Ladies and gentlemen, is a rare collection of speeches rendered by Justice Narayana Kurup, covering a wide spectrum of subjects such as law, medicine, engineering, chartered accountancy, science and technology, music, mountaineering, spirituality, nuclear embargo, human rights, corruption, torture, global warming, inspirational talk to youth, and so on, which every student should read to groom up as an informed individual and to be a success in life. About the author of Ladies and Gentlemen.
Born in North Parur, Kerala, India, in the year 1939, Justice Narayana Kurup had his primary education in his native village. After schooling, he graduated in chemistry from the Madras University, followed by graduation and post-graduation in law from the Kerala University. Enrolled as an advocate of the Kerala High Court Bar in 1964, he was appointed as counsel for the government of Kerala and the government of India in the High Court for a fairly long period. He also served as part-time professor in constitutional law in the Government Law College, Ernakulam. His elevation to the bench in 1992 witnessed judicial activism at its pinnacle, culminating in the historic verdict which he wrote for the division bench of the High Court of Kerala banning smoking in public. Towards the fag end of his judicial career, he took over as the senior most judge of the prestigious 200-year-old Chartered High Court of Madras, from where he laid on office in 2001 after a stint there as acting Chief Justice.
With this background, let us scan Ladies and Gentlemen, dedicated to the memory of K.R. Narayanan, former President of India. Sri Somnath Chatterjee, Honorable Speaker, Lok Sabha, has contributed the foreword, followed by a prologue by Dr. M.S. Valiathan, National Research Professor. A tribute to the author, Justice V.R. Krishna Iyer, and an epilogue by Professor C.R. Shankara Menon. In Ladies and Gentlemen, Justice Kurup speaks of success as presupposing proper aim and the right ammunition, and it comes to those who fight and bounce back, as in the case of Abraham Lincoln, Columbus, Napoleon, Leonardo da Vinci, Gandhiji, Churchill, Einstein, Keynes, Charles Darwin, Wilma Rudolph, Socrates, and a host of others. The Gita, as a gate to the youth who are in a state of dilemma like Arjuna. The Bible as generating a new wave of hope and optimism to millions. All religions as leading to the same goal, and one religion is not in any way inferior or superior to another. Adi Shankara, as the noblest of Advaita philosophers and one of the most vigorous missionaries of the country. Surya, as the divine viewfire and the need to tap solar energy, since our fossil fuels are getting depleted at an alarming rate. Spirituality as a great resistance against various ailments. Independence of the judiciary as dependent on the quality of the individual judges, and that judicial education and training should aim at molding a new generation of judges with absolute rectitude and integrity. The threat of the judiciary debasing to low levels. The necessity of lawyers and judges being well versed in other subjects. Incompetency of judges as leading to unpardonable delays. The doctor-patient relationship as one of utmost trust and confidence. Medical errors due to various contributing factors, and one single doctor cannot be made liable for the entire episode. Romance between doctors and patients. The constitution as what the judges say it is, and absence of judicial review will create a constitutional despot beyond the pale of accountability, a Frankenstein monster. the responsibility of every press. Tobacco as the greatest killer. The role that courts can play in triggering socially relevant action. The necessity to devise cost-effective housing. Greatness as a blend of ability and opportunity. The magnitude of child labor. Social and economic disparities assuming sickening dimensions. The important role films play in molding our society. The role of ethics as a safeguard against abuse of technology. Scientific advancements distorting the humane face of medicine. Similar to the last rites of the church, medicine too has some last rites. An obligatory period on a ventilator without which a patient is not allowed to die. Alcohol as injuring people internally, externally and eternally. The pitfalls of clinical research. Humanism in animal research. The importance of continuing medical education. Dental surgeons as the best smile consultants. Heart attack as a preventable earthquake. Engineers to be visionaries. Therapeutic partnership between doctors and patients minimizing medical errors to the same low level seen in other high risk ventures like aviation and nuclear fission. The human dignity of the mentally ill. Laments the plight of the mentally retarded and cautions the medical professionals to be careful in administering drugs to pregnant women and reminds them the golden rule that all women are pregnant until proved otherwise. Dementia as a sine qua non collapse into second childhood. Had Cleopatra's nose been shorter, the whole face of the world would have changed. Today, personal appearance is a greater recommendation than any letter of introduction. People not only want to feel good inside, they also want to look good outside. The intellectual and emotional immaturity of the medical profession. In the context of foul breath, the most important component of a person's success in life is to get a good toothbrush and not degrees and diplomas. The need to correct the alignments of political parties by bridging and bracing devices by dental surgeons. Walking to be the best exercise that people of all ages can do. The importance of organ donation. Lifestyle changes as the best armor against cardiovascular events. Chartered accountants to be watchdogs but not bloodhounds with total independence to curb financial fraud and malpractices. Somnath Chatterjee as classically bold and forthright in his views to maintain the delicate constitutional balance between legislature and judiciary. Important role of the merchant navy in boosting the economy of the nation. Socratic definition of the qualities of a judge: to hear courteously, to answer wisely, to consider soberly, and to decide impartially. The task of the judiciary to fulfill the expectations of the deprived and neglected multitude. Judicial career as a mixture of agony and ecstasy, ups and downs, trials and tribulations. Indian judiciary as a highly proactive one, even to the envy of other democracies in the world. The scourge of global warming. A better world through better habitat and housing as fundamental to the healthy growth and development of the individual, since it is there that an Iago or Idi Amin is born, sinner or saint is made, lawmaker or lawbreaker is made. Living wage as a distant dream. The necessity to utilize the vintage experience, professional proficiency and accumulated wisdom of senior citizens rare to be seen in the younger generation. The ugly face of the new trade regime. LIC as a true symbol of India. The unifying power of music. The lessons we have to learn from mountaineering. The role of the NRIs in Kerala's urban development. Torture as involving the entire gamut of human rights violations in day-to-day life, the whole set of deprivations a human being suffers in a civilized society. the dire need to fight corruption. Suicide as a man rushing into the presence of his maker unasked. Nuclear energy as an effective substitute for fossil fuel. Poor management as the root cause of tardy waste disposal. The horrors of nuclear warfare in which both the victor and the vanquished will perish and cremated equal. Metro rail, a retrograde concept for Cochin.
Great quotes on reading. Let us read and let us dance. Two things that will never do any harm to the world. Voltaire. This will never be a civilized country until we expend more money for books than we do for chewing gum. Voltaire. Not all readers are leaders, but all leaders are readers. Harry S. Truman. A book can have 500 pages, but only a single page may change the reader's life. Anonymous. Children are made readers on the laps of their parents. Emily Bouchard. A book is the most effective weapon against intolerance and ignorance. Lyndon Baines Johnson. There is no substitute for books in the life of a man. May Ellen Chase. Reading is a basic tool for living good life. Mortimer Adler. A man is known by the books he reads. Emerson. Today, a reader. Tomorrow, a leader. Fusselman. What is reading but silent conversation? Walter Savage Landor. Reading gives us solitary reflection and true enjoyment. Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, first Vice President and the second President of India. Sir Visheshwaraya Institute of Technology has started Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Library for enhancing the reading habits of the young generation. Books become permanent companions. Sometimes they are born before us. They guide us during our life journey and continue for many generations. Bill Gates is well known for reading one book a week. Mark Zuckerberg reads a new book every other week. Warren Buffett reads between 600 to 1,000 pages per day. Stay curious. Reading keeps you curious. There are many ways to success and only two ways to fail. One, don't read anything. And two, don't keep trying. Late at night, Abraham Lincoln could be found reading by candlelight. Reading helped pull Lincoln out of poverty and into the White House. Both Einstein and Picasso were diligent readers and both were inspired by books. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam stressed the need to develop reading habits among students. Reading makes a full man. Climb the tree of knowledge and remember, knowledge is power. A good book is your best friend. Reading is to the mind what exercise is to the body. The Prime Minister exhorts youth to read more. Give a book, not bouquet, as greeting. Prime Minister Narendra Modi. According to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, there is no joy greater than reading and no strength greater than knowledge. Comments on Ladies and Gentlemen. The book is inspiring and thought-provoking at once, and I hope that Ladies and Gentlemen will be read by all interested, especially students, political scientists, academics, and civil society leaders. Somada Chatterjee, Speaker, House of the People. A great attraction of Justice Kurup's speeches is their astonishing range. M.S. Veliyathan, National Research Professor. This is an agreeable, reflective, and often profound book. This book is a pleasure to encounter, not least because this author enjoys a concise and crisp writing style, as clear as a window pane. Adina Press, London, Reader's Report. The lectures are studied with apt examples drawn from history, political events, scriptures, manners and morals. In his speech, calling upon the youth to perform their duties with commitment, Kurup quotes Emerson's words, "Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail." The Hindu, A Man for All Seasons, Book Review. Ladies and gentlemen, touched on a diversity of topics. The New Indian Express, Book Review. Ladies and Gentlemen is a comprehensive collection of learned papers and lovely speeches, deserves to be read by everyone who wants to know something more about any topic under the sun. Justice V.R. Krishna Iyer, a tribute to the author. A precious diamond has 64 faces. Ladies and Gentlemen has 67 flashes, irreplaceable. What else? Professor C.R. Shankara Menon. I am sure that the book will be a useful asset for universities as well as educational institutions. Pratibha Devi Singh Patil, President, Republic of India.
Let us now rise for the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and